special presentation from American Experience and Frontline. It is one of the world's fastest growing religions. Its members project pride in their faith and confidence in their future. They walk the corridors of power, leaders in Congress, and even running for president. But for the Mormons, it was not always so.
In the 19th century, to call someone a Mormon was akin to calling someone a Muslim terrorist.
Tonight, Frontline and American Experience join forces to tell the story of one of the most powerful, feared, and misunderstood religions in American history.
A column of light appeared in his room, and then a person came down, very glowing person.
He says he's the angel Moroni. And so he begins to tell Joseph about the Book of Mormon.
This is the story of Joseph Smith and the revelations that gave birth to a new faith born in America.
What outraged the traditional Christians of the day was that this guy comes along and he says, I am the prophet for this new age.
The story of religious conflict and persecution.
When that mob stormed Carthen's jail and shot the prophet Joseph, they thought they were finishing off Mormonism as a movement.
And the story of a people who crossed a continent to establish their own spiritual kingdom.
Brigham Young is telling the federal government to back off from the Utah Territory. We will take care of ourselves.
And of a church that for decades defied society by embracing polygamy and then abruptly abandoned it.
How do you go from being the ultimate outcast to the embodiment of the mainstream in two generations? It's a breathtaking transformation.
This is the story of a modern religion still full of old missionary zeal.
It was, for all intents and purposes, mandatory for young men to go on missions. You go, you go, you go. Dad went, Grandpa went.
A culture proud of its strong communities and close-knit families.
The church and my family are so intertwined. It just creates a kind of aura of love and peace.
But a church that will exile those who defy its authority and its teachings.
That culture is beyond hell, and I was committing a kind of spiritual suicide.
And yet, a faith that offers its followers powerful spiritual gifts.
The temple exists as a kind of vehicle through which we conquer mortality. Not a single atom or particle of our bodies will be lost, but everything will be reconstituted as fully as it was. It's almost a kind of celebration of the totality of triumph over death.
Tonight, the epic story of this very American religion. The history, the controversies, and the mysteries of the Mormons.
American Experience is made possible by the Alfred P. Sloan Foundation to enhance public understanding of the role of technology. The foundation also seeks to portray the lives of the men and women engaged in scientific and technological pursuits.
Imagine what the world would be like if everyone did the right thing. Responsibility. What's your policy?
At the Scotts Company, we help make gardens more beautiful. Lawns greener. Trees taller. If there's a better business to be in, please let us know.
And the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. Funding for Frontline and American Experience is made possible by viewers like you. Thank you. Additional funding for Frontline is provided by the Park Foundation, committed to raising public awareness. Additional funding for the Mormons is provided by the following. And others. A complete list is available.